Hello, my name is Toby from Art Master Studio, and this is a studio update. I haven't done one of these in a while, so I thought, you know, I'll get one going for the channel since we've not been uploading too much lately. So these are some 28mm World War II Africa Corps. I believe they're all Perry miniatures. These bikes here actually are from Warlord Bolt Action. But these ones in the box here, these are all plastics from the Perry plastic set. So what we've gone for here is a variety of tans and sandy colours. I'll just zoom in so I can go over them a little bit. So the basic premise is the uniforms would have been kind of a greeny drab colour when they were brand new, but quickly in the intense heat of the sun they would have faded and got much lighter. So over time you would have had lots of variations of sand and tan and like khaki sort of colour. So that's kind of what we've gone for here. We've got a few that were closer to the original greeny drab colour, but what recruits, newbies would often dye their uniforms so they didn't stand out as much. So for instance, this guy here, if I just bring him forward, so he's in more of the original colour that they would have came in, but you know, he'd obviously stand out quite a bit from the crowd, so he might have decided to dye his uniform to look more like this guy here. So quick, my thoughts on the figures themselves. Normally I'm not too much of a fan of plastics. They do have their place and I think that they can be quite nice. I mean, as you can see, these ones look fairly good actually. The Perrys have done quite a good job, I think. But yeah, the detail on them, They have got crisp detail, and compared to the actual metal ones that Perry do, I actually prefer the plastic ones. I think the metal Perry ones are a little bit of a letdown. They seem a little bit rushed to me. But you know, that's personal opinion, I guess. But yeah, the plastic ones have got, you know, they've got quite a lot of detail, and they've got a nice command set with like a radio here, which is very nice. Nice crisp detail on that. Let's see, here's an officer. He's quite nice. Some of the details are a little bit subtle, but that's to be expected with plastics. Let's zoom out a little bit more. As you can see, this one in the left here is black. I'm saving him for a full video tutorial, so you can look forward to that. I'll quickly show you the colours that I've gone for. I've used four different colours here. You can see there's a lot of variety overall. They all look different, even though there's only four colours. So you don't need to use too many colours to get a nice sort of campaign look to them. So yeah, I used US Field Drab for one undercoat, and I lightened that with light mud. So that's one colour. Then more of a sandy colour was a base coat of Vallejo English Uniform, and then lightened first highlight with German Camo Orange Ochre, and then highlight British Tank Crew. Have to excuse my doggies making some noise. I like to get involved in the videos. Okay, so next colour, we've got beige brown. Where is that one? Here we go. So this is a nice sandy one as well, with a nice warm tone to it, and that was lightened with desert yellow. See if I can find that one. Oh yeah, there it is. Yep. Nice desert yellow colour there. And the final one. What was the final one? So we've done English uniform, US field drab, desert yellow. Oh yeah, and then the more khaki colour, which is actually the English uniform colour that we use for World War II British. So that's starting with burnt umber, and then there we go, and then English uniform, and then khaki grey. Actually, the Germans would have used a lot of stolen British uniforms as well, so that you know that works for that quite nicely. So I'll be posting photos of these when they're all finished on our Facebook page. You might see them in an advert or two. If you've got any questions, please leave them in the comments below. As I said before, I'll be doing a video tutorial anyway. Also, there's a little bit of nice weathering on some of the helmets, like this guy, and some of the gas canisters there, gas mask holders. So yeah, overall I'm really impressed with them. Let me know what you think of the models themselves, and I'll see you in the next one.